اوكي، ناوي الاكسبلين ليكتشر 10 ان الكترونكس. ليكتشر 10 توكس اباوت سام انسولفد اكزامبلز فروم بريفيوس ليكتشرز. ذيس اكزامبلز اكزيست ان ليكتشر 4 اند ليكتشر 6. وي didn't solve these examples on time, so we'll solve these examples now. Example 1 and 2 are from lecture 4. Examples 3 is from lecture 6. Okay. For example 1, it asks to get value of V, will value of I1 and value of I2. I1 is the current that passed through resistor 10. I2 is the current that passed through resistor through this branch. So it is the current that passed through resistor 25 and 15. For V, V is the voltage across the two components. The 25 and the 30, since its scope is around these two components, okay, positive and negative. So the V value will be the V over 25 ohm resistor plus the volt at the, so, this source, which has a value of 30. Okay. Well, I1 is the current that passes through the I of 10 ohm. Well, I2, as I said, I2 is the current that passes through the resistor 25 and 50. Okay. So, since this lecture is for this example from lecture 4, so we will solve it using any method that we took until lecture 4. Lecture 4, until lecture 4, we took KCL, KVL, current division, voltage division, and Ohm's law. So we have to solve using these two methods. In general, if this example appeared to you during the quiz, during the midterm, during the final, you have to solve using any method you prefer. You are not limited with any method. But for this example, we will solve using rules that we took until lecture 4. So to get I1 is the current that passed through the 10 ampere, sorry, the 10 ohm. Where the current is equal to V over R, so it will be R is 10 and V is 19. Why 90? Since this source is parallel with this source, so they will have the same voltage. This source has a voltage of 90 volt, so this series resistor will have the same volt. So the current will be 90 over 10, which is 9 ampere. So this is the value of I1. For I2, we can apply KVL to get I2. I2 is the current that passes through this loop. Okay. So after applying the KVL in this loop, we will do summation of voltages in this element and this element and this element and also this element, okay? So the question will have four elements, element of 1, 2, 3, 4. The first element is the voltage across the resistor 25. The volt is I multiplied by R. The R value is 25 and the I is I2. Since this resistor, the current that passed through this resistor is 2. Then we will do summation of 30. Then plus voltage across this element, which is I multiplied by R. R is 15, I is I2. Then we will do summation of volt at this component, which is has a value of 19. Voltage at this component is 19, as we said before. The volt at R equal the volt at 10 ohm equal 19, since a parallel. Okay. So the voltage will be 90, but we add a negative sign since the current in this branch is not the same current direction of this branch. So the equation will be minus 19 equals 0. After solving this equation has only one variable. After solving, we'll have I2. Again, this equation can be said as 25 I2 plus 30 plus 15 I2 plus 10 multiplied by I2 minus I1. Equal 0. So you can apply KVL using this equation or this equation. This is the equation that we used for, but this is a for this element, we substitute directly by the value of the voltage. You can write this equation and substitute by the value of the current I1. Then we will get a current value of I2, which is 1.5. The third requirement is to get the value of LV. Again, LV is the voltage across these two components. The 25 resistor or 25 ohm and the 30 volt. The volt as this component is I multiplied by R. I is I2 and R is 25. So the final value of the volt will be this value. Okay. This is all for this example. For this example, it asks to get the value of LV1 using the voltage division rule. The voltage division rule states that to get the volt of a specific R, it will be the value of R over this R plus any other R that is series with it. Okay? Then we will multiply by the voltage source. So to get a value of V1, which is the value across the 18 ohm, it will be equals to the 18 over the 18 plus uh, 54 multiplied by the V source. The V source is not this value of the V source. The V source is the V source of this component. The V source is the voltage of this component. Okay. So we have to get this value to solve the value of the V1. Okay, to get the value of V1, to get the value of V1, this will be the equation. But we this is the V source that we would like to get, but we don't know till now how this value equals to 48. So to get this 48, we have to first of all get the equivalent resistor of the circuit of this part of the circuit. This part of the circuit, 54 and 80 are series together, so their equivalent value is 72. They are parallel with 36. So their equivalent value will be 72 multiplied by 36 over 72 plus 36, which will have 24. So this circuit will be simplified to be have this resistor series with L16, the original 16. Okay, this is the simplified circuit. First step is to get this equation and search for the V source value. Second step is to get the equivalent resistor for this part. Then the result of the resistor will be this circuit. the third step is to get the V. LV for this resistor, LV at 24 will be L24 plus any series resistor with it, which is 16, multiplied by its voltage source, which is now 18. So the value will be 48. So the voltage across this resistor is 48. The first step is to conclude that V at resistor 24 is the same as the resistor the voltage at the resistor 72 and the voltage at the resistor 36, since they are their equivalent resistor, okay, for 24 these two resistors, okay? So the volt at this component will be the same volt at this component and the same volt at this component, since they are parallel. So the volt at 24 is the same volt as 72. Where the volt at 72 is the same as is the source of the 18. This 17 is the equivalent resistor for these two components. So it is the voltage source of these two components. Okay? The volt of 24 equal volt of 72. The volt of 24 is 48. So the volt at 72 equal the volt at 18. Since it is the source of this volt equal the volt of 18. Since it is the source of this two series component, okay? So to get the value of the V1, it will be 18 over 18 plus 54 multiplied by 48, which will be 12, okay? For the third example, it's about the mesh analysis. Example three asked to get the value of the I1, the I2, and the I3 using the mesh analysis method. To solve this example using the mesh analysis method, we have to define the number of meshes. We have mesh one, mesh two, mesh three. The current value in this mesh is called I2, I1, sorry, and the current in this mesh is I3, and this is I2. We can refer to this current as I1, I2, I3. They are dummy variables. But for this example, it's solved that, assuming that this is I2, I1, I3, and I2. But for sure, they are the same. Okay. You can answer by assuming that the current in mesh one is I1, in mesh two is I2, in mesh three is I3. We can assume that this is mesh one, this is mesh two, and this is mesh three. Or we can assume that this is mesh one, mesh three, and mesh two. They are the same. Okay, what is the main problem of this example? The third step in mesh analysis, the first step is to define the mesh, the second step is to define the current in a mesh, the third step is to apply KVL in every mesh. So after applying KVL in this mesh, this mesh has no problem, we will do the summation of voltage as these three components that exist in this mesh. But in this mesh, if I would like to apply KVL, I couldn't do a summation of voltages since this source is a current source. So I couldn't do summation voltage, so I couldn't apply KVL in this example. Okay, for this mesh, if I would like to apply KVL, I have to do summation of voltage at this component and this component and this component, but this component is a current source, so I couldn't apply KVL in this equation. This is a special case in mesh analysis method called the common current source, in which there is a current source between two meshes, this mesh one and this mesh two. There is a current source between two meshes, okay? So how to solve this special case? The first solution is to use source transformation. Source transformation is to search for a resistor that is parallel with this source and convert this component to be a resistor with a series with a voltage source, okay? So to solve this example using source transformation, first you have to search for a resistor that is parallel with this source. Then we will convert this component, this part of the circuit, which contain a current source parallel with a resistor, to this shape. This shape contain a current source, a resistor with a voltage source, series together. Okay. The remaining circuit remains the same, 6 ohm, 30 volt, and this volt source, okay? After making this step, we will apply, the second step is to apply mesh analysis normally, mesh analysis normally. Okay, after making source transformation, the current source is removed. So I will search for the meshes, which is mesh one and mesh two. The current in mesh one is I1, the current in mesh two is I2. The third step is to apply KVL. Third step in mesh analysis is to apply KVL on each mesh. After applying KVL on mesh one, I will have this equation, minus 75 plus 4 multiplied by plus 5 multiplied by I1 minus I2. Plus 65 equals 0. This KVL for this mesh. To apply KVL in this mesh, I will have this equation. The volt at this component is 6 I2. The volt at this component is 30 plus 30. Then the volt at this component will be negative 65 plus 5 multiplied by I1 minus I2. Equals 0. So I will have two equations with two variables. I have to solve them to get the I1 and the I2. Then the I3 for this example, I3 equal I1 minus 8. While I3 equal I1 minus I2, since for this example, after assuming current that pass in this direction, it will be entering this node from this direction, I1. And after assuming current direction is I2, so it will be leaving this node from this direction. And the current in this branch is called I3. So the I3 will be I1 minus I2, or I1 first. I have I1. Current entering this node is I1. Current leaving this node is I3 and I2. So I1 equal I2 plus I3. So I will have I3 equal I1 minus I2. Okay. This is the first solution for this problem. Second solution for this problem. Is to use something called super mesh. Super mesh is a mesh that is resulted after removing the current, the common current source. Okay, a super mesh is a mesh that is resulted after removing the common current source. Okay, so if we remove this source, we will have this super mesh. Okay. So we can apply the KVL on this loop and this big loop. This will solve the problem since we will neglect this current source. So first step is to define the super mesh in your circuit, then to apply the mesh analysis in your circuit. This is solved using defining the number of meshes in your circuit, which is mesh one and mesh two, to define the current in each mesh, which is I1 and I2. Okay. Then apply KVL on each mesh. After applying KVL on mesh one, I will have this equation, which do summation of three voltages. These are the three voltages, volt at this component, volt at this component, and this component. The volt here is for I1. The volt at this component will be 5 multiplied by I1 minus I3. I1, current in this branch, this is I1. Current in this branch is I1 minus I3. Okay. Since the current in this original loop is I3 and this is I2, okay? Then the voltage at this component is negative 75. This is all for this loop. Then we will apply KVL for the second mesh, in which we will do submission of three elements, of three voltages. This element and this element and this element. The volt at this element is I multiplied by R, which is 6 multiplied by I2. And the volt here is 30. And volt here is 5 multiplied by I3 minus I1. Okay. And the component here is 5 multiplied by I1 minus I3. You know, 5 multiplied by S3 minus I1. Okay. This is after applying the KVL in this mesh. Till now, I have two equations with three variables, I1, I3, and I2. So I have to get a third equation to solve the three equations, to get the three variables. The third equation will be resulting third equation says that L13 equal I2 minus I3. After looking to this node, you can find that the current is out of this node in this direction, which is has a value of 30. And the current in this loop is called I2. And the current in this direction is I3. So this node has a current entering it, which is I2, equal, and have two currents that is leaving this node, which is 30 and I3, 30 plus I3. If I get the 30 in only one side, I will get this equation, which is 30 equals I2 minus I3. Okay. We have to solve these two equations to get three equations to get the values of I1 and I2. This is all for this lecture.